Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, we're going to be exploring how to use NX Sketch to implement new design changes we need to make. More specifically, we are going to investigate how to create sketches on desired planes, fully dimension our sketches, and take our sketches into actionable design changes. We are starting with this copy machine, and there is a complex component that I would like to add an additional face onto. Once we've isolated the part we want to work on, we can begin by selecting Sketch from the left side under our Home tab. Doing this will open a new window where we can select the location of the plane we will use to create our sketch. For simple sketches, the Inferred option is usually the most efficient way to determine your sketch plane. However, many instances will require a more complex plane location. To select a more unique plane location, we can begin by changing our plane method from Inferred to new plane. Here, we can select an existing plane, or we can opt to choose the plane dialog button. The plane dialog button once again begins by offering inferred planes, but if we select this dropdown, there is a number of other options, including planes at a distance from existing planes and at an angle. For our purposes today, we're just going to use the at angle option. With this selected, we are given a series of prompts to follow to properly set up our new plane. First, we need to choose our planar object, which will be the basis of our new plane. Next, we must select the axis our plane will be rotated around. And the last step is choosing the angle we want our plane to be at, relative to our initial planar object. Once we're set, we can choose OK, and we can select our axis and origin point. The sketch orientation option is currently set to horizontal, so that means we are going to be choosing a vector to use for our x-axis. For this scenario, we can just choose our axis of rotation from before. And for the sketch origin, I'm going to select the corner of this part. With the plane, orientation, and origin now set, we can begin to work on the sketch we want to produce. For the purposes of this video, we're going to look at building a rectangular extension from the body of our part containing two holes. To begin designing this, we can start by selecting the rectangle tool, and then select the location of two opposite corners. From here, I'm going to begin dimensioning as we develop our sketch. It's important for a number of reasons that as you go, you keep your sketch fully defined. This encourages precision, helps in manufacturing, and promotes consistency across your designs. To dimension a line, we can simply click on the line we would like to parameterize. NX will recognize this means we are ready to dimension, and we can easily change the value of our line's length. Additionally, if we would like to add a dimension from one point or line to another, we can select both consecutively, and NX will recognize again we are ready to dimension. One important note to make is that when our sketch is highlighted in brown, it is not fully defined. Once it is fully defined, the sketch outline will turn black to signal it is ready for the next steps of the design process. With the rectangle finished, we can move on to adding circles inside of our rectangle. Again, we will need to dimension these to make sure our sketch is fully defined. One easy way to do this is using a reference line. To create a reference line, we can right-click on an existing line, and the first icon in the upper left corner will switch this to a reference line. This is useful to ensure alignment in your sketches while promoting consistency and organization. Additionally, there are a couple of other tricks for dimensioning circles. Selecting the circle along its edge will allow us to dimension the radius, while if we hover over the circle, we can select its center mark, which can help dimension the circle to other items in the sketch. The last changes I would like to make before we finish our sketch is to simply add fillets to the corners of our rectangle. To do this, we select the fillet tool and enter our desired radius. If we click and drag across each corner, the fillets will automatically populate in with a dimension on the first corner. With our sketch fully defined, we are now ready to select, finish, and wrap up our last design changes. The last step we need to perform to make this sketch part of our model is to extrude and then unite it with the existing body. This is a simple step that can be found in the base section of the Home tab. For the extrude, we will want to extend the sketch until it reaches the next face. Once that is done, we can select Unite under the Boolean section of this command window, and now our new extrusion will be included with the existing part. In conclusion, in this video, we've explored some of the basic aspects of creating a sketch in NX. To start, we looked at the Create Sketch dialog window, where we dove into selecting a plane that met our design needs. After this, we began to create our simple sketch, paying close attention to fully dimensioning each line and curve, while also looking at how we could utilize reference lines. And finally, we wrap things up by extruding the sketch and uniting it with the existing body. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.